Almost a year has passed after the first ritual during the lockdown, which was Ostara. At the time, the whole situation was new and nobody thought it would last a whole year. But here we are. Last year was hard on all of us. On one hand, we had more time for reflection and walks alone in the nature, which, as urban pagans, we highly lack. On another, there were no circles, no hand-holding, no togetherness at the Sabbaths. Virtual rituals were a new thing, and I was truly curious how it's gonna go and what possibilities it will bring. I managed to celebrate Ostara with 3 covens in one day, from the comfort of my own home. Well, as I'm editing this now, a year later, virtual rituals are no news anymore. Everyone is longing for the live events. And I'm hopeful that soon we will be back outdoors, celebrating the new wheel of the year, starting the Ostara 2021.
Youth of the spring, wild running stag, young lover, we call to you to bring the fresh breezes, the passion of new life and love, the greening and the young animals running free. Be with us and bring the blessings of spring on this day. We bid you hail and welcome.
Hail and welcome.
There is no flower has the charm of all, the sea glow's purity, the everlasting strength, the mountain lily's warmth. But who knows whether there is no love that holds all, friendship, passion, worship, such is the love of the gods. Such a love will fall on the surface of strong, cold, selfish life, as the sunlight falls on a torpid winter world. There, where the trees are bare and the ground frozen, till it rings to the step like iron, and the water is solid, and the air is sharp as a two-edged knife that cuts unwary. But when Ostara returns to the earth, through its whole dead crust a throbbing yearning wakes. The trees feel her, and every knot and bud swell, aching to open to her. The brown seeds who have slept deep under the ground feel her, and she gives them strength, till they break through the frozen earth and lift 2 tiny trembling green hands in love to her. And she touches the water, till down to its depths it feels her and melts, and it flows, and the things, strange sweet things that were locked up in it, sing as it runs for love of her. Each plant tries to bear at least 1 fragrant little flower for her. And the world that was dead lives, and the heart that was dead and self-centered throbs with an upward, outward yearning, and it has become that which it seemed impossible ever to become. Hail, Ostara, love is in
praise to the Lady and the Lord.
see come to fruition? What are your new light plans? Meditate on that and then charge your seeds with that. If you don't have a seed, you can just meditate on that desire, that goal, that abstract seed, and send it into the universe when we plant.
Ostara, Lago, this is our prayer for spring, that your resplendent light, your love and wisdom color every leaf, so beautify all things. So as death must be undergone, so must new birth.
We thank you, dear gods, for these gifts of nature's bounty, so life nourishes life. As all food is of the gods, so all food is sacred. So would it be.
So would it be.
May you never hunger.
May we never hunger.
May you never thirst.
May we never thirst.
This is Ostara's world, the birds that fire.
Our hearts guard your flames. Camphora. Soft-scented stillness that warns of the storm. Whisper of knowledge, full living and warm. You breathed in us wonder at all we may know. Farewell, wise wind, to wherever you blow. Hail and farewell.
Oh, how sweet is thy golden honey, the sacred nectar from the comb. From the bees down in the valley, where our Bridget calls her home. Come now, Bridget, come we call you, mistress of the forge and well. Come now, Bridget, come we call you, may we in your presence dwell. Kindred of the great flame, kept by prudent skill, mind with our common heart that these flames be one. Kindred of the great flame, kept by prudent skill, joined with our common heart that these flames be one. Kindred of the great flame, kept by prudent skill, joined with a common heart that these flames be one.
Outlanders, Valmorians, want to have a beautiful ritual. Please allow us to do so in peace.
Oh, candy. They would love that.
Away until we do so. These offerings, ginger, dark chocolate, and some wine.
Oh, yeah.
Please enjoy. Please enjoy your own corner. I'll be right back.
Okay. We gather this afternoon from our various locations throughout New York City. We come together to celebrate the balancing of light and dark, to celebrate the spring equinox, the beginning of spring, the blossoming of spring. We come to celebrate with each other, to support each other in these extraordinary times. My prayer for this ritual is that we come together and that we are sustained, that our spirits are lifted, that we feel the connection with one another, even though there's great distance between us, and that with the help of Aphrodite and the Shining Ones and all the wonderful spirits around us, that we learn self-care for ourselves, be mindful of self-care for ourselves in this ritual and in the coming days.
We thought what we could do for purification is to wash our hands, very topical. I'd like you to literally wash your hands, and as you're doing it, send this purification out that you're accomplishing on yourself to everyone here at the ritual. Okay, so I'm gonna step away for a second. I'm gonna wash my hands.
Okay.
And I'll be back in a moment.
Okay, I'm back.
I know that we are all wrapping each other in a cloud of cleanliness.
So, Mother Gaia, we welcome you into our ritual. You are the earth. You are the very organism in which we live out our lives in total. And we are so grateful to be a part of your creation. Please accept these offerings. Welcome, Mother Gaia.
Welcome, Mother Gaia.
Accept these offerings. Gaia, hail and welcome.
Ora Great Sky Father, original Sky Father, force of nature, we call on you today. We ask you for your guidance and your blessings. You who are Father of Venus, we call on you to guide us and help us in this self-care ritual. I offer you these bare naked granolas. Uranus, lover of Gaia, you bring us air and inspiration and light so that the grains can grow. We offer you these grains in return. Uranus, accept this sacrifice.
Uranus,
hail and welcome. Hermes, Trimajestis, we call on you for inspiration, and now we give you three times the almonds for three times the Hermes. You who are the messenger of the gods and the cycle pump of the soul, we call on you today to be our inspiration for this ritual honoring Aphrodite and asking for self-care. So I offer you these almonds, which I know you like. Hermes, accept this offering.
I thought you said olives.
Accept these offerings.
What's that? It was giving olives instead. I wondered why your almonds were in a jar of liquid.
That's right. Hermes loves shit.
Hey, he's Greek. He probably loves all of shit.
Yeah, he also is playful, so yeah. Yes. First I have this big chunk of rose quartz. Rose quartz is usually for love, which Aphrodite is the goddess of. But I want this to represent this represents the land that we stand on, but it also represents Mount Olympus, where the gods reside. Then I have some water, which I'm gonna pour over here so it doesn't spill on my bed. This bowl of water represents the waters from the deep and all around us and all around our piece of land. For us, it would be maybe the Hudson and the East River and all the waters below. But I also want this waters to represent the River Styx and the underworld. So I'll put little Mount Olympus on top here in the bowl. And then I have these feathers to represent the sky. And although these are hawk feathers, I know eagle's really a Zeus thing, but I feel like I want these to represent Zeus and his, and with that, our cosmos is recreated.
So Hecate. Great tripartite goddess, goddess of witches, goddess of the crossroads, goddess of locks and keys. We invite you here today to our ritual, honoring Aphrodite and the spring equinox. This is the time of year when light and dark are equal, We ask you to look over and bless both the light and the dark. And so we ask you now, Hecate, please join us. Hecate, accept these offerings.
Hecate, accept these offerings.
Hecate, accept these offerings.
Let us gather all of our energies to yours. And let the gates be open.
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 Thank you, great Hecate.
Hail and welcome all our ancestors to help us and give us love and peace in this uncertain time. Hail and welcome.
Hail and welcome.
Ancestors, hail and welcome.
Welcome, nature spirits. Those who are awake already and those who are still asleep, we welcome you. I know the spring is coming despite what's happening on Earth. The nature never stops for any person or persons. So welcome. I have some rum for you. And I have some rye bread for the nature spirits. Hail and welcome.
Hail and welcome.
Nature spirit. Hail and welcome.
So we have representation of the seashell. So I always see her as a ruby. I know that Chris said rose quartz, but for me, she's a ruby. And she's around and she's the goddess of love. And I've worked with her since I can remember. And I didn't always take her seriously, and I think that might have been a problem to a certain extent. She probably is pissed at me that I'm sort of don't have makeup on and I'm just kind of freewheeling it right now because she wants everybody to love themselves and be beautiful and their best version, and that's what she really pushes you to do. And so if we can be the best versions of ourselves, especially right now, and then push that forward into the universe, I think we can stave off a lot of mental illness and a lot of trauma. So Aphrodite, if you would come and join and help us make that a reality and help us focus on being the best versions of ourselves, we would appreciate that. Hail and welcome, Aphrodite.
Hail and welcome,
Aphrodite.
You know, we're focused on the gift that she's giving us here is that she says it's a noble cause what we're doing, and that fortune will come to us, but also strife. So it's a balance of those two things at least. But she's still encouraging us to work day by day and to give us a blessing of self-care. But if you want to infuse something that you use for your self-care, like I decided I want to infuse the blessings of Aphrodite into this honey. So, or it could be like a beauty product that you use or something like that. So whatever you feel like you want to bring, you can go get it now before we do the prayer, before we do any of the blessings.
Aphrodite, subtle of soul and deathless, daughter of God, weaver of wiles, I pray thee, neither with care, dread mistress, nor with anguish, slay thou my spirit. Hail Aphrodite.
Hail Aphrodite.
Hail Aphrodite.
Come to me now thus, goddess, and release me from distress and pain, and all my distracted heart would seek. Do thou, once again fulfilling, still be my ally. Hail Aphrodite.
Hail Aphrodite.
All pretty cool.
To join us in this ritual. To bless us in this ritual. To give us your power in this ritual. And for us to have a chance to worship you. And to give us to give you some of our adoration as nectar and ambrosia to you. So, shining ones, great Greek gods, accept this offering.
Shining ones, great shining Greek ones. Gods.
Welcome.
This offering.
Shining ones, Greek deities, hail and welcome.
Shining ones, Greek deities, hail and welcome.
Hail and welcome.
All right. Remember me telling you guys just a few minutes ago, I think Christelle missed that. We have a picture on in the online group that says Astral Temple. I want you guys to envision that. That's our temple space that we're in. That's where we're going. And you guys can each put some energies into that temple, that kind of a thing, okay? I want you guys to take a deep breath and take a moment to visualize and feel our astral temple. As the wheel of the year turns once more, as we honor nature's balance and returning to the world, light and dark, and the soil begins to change as the earth awakens from its slumber, a new life springs forth as we are welcomed to this rite of spring. Burn fire, burn bright, your vision come to me.
I do conjure that this be a circle of power and of love, a circle that will be a barrier of protection and a meeting place between the world of humanity and the realm of the mighty ones. And this circle shall contain and protect the power we shall raise within it. I bless and consecrate this circle in the names of the Mother Goddess and the Horned God. The circle is now cast. Let none leave it, but with good cause. So mote it be.
So mote it be.
Water and earth, let this place be purified for our purpose. So mote it be.
So mote it be.
Fire and air, let this temple be consecrated to our purpose. So mote it be.
So mote it be.
In the east, I call the powers of air to join our circle this night and bid you welcome. Hail and welcome, blessed be.
Hail and welcome, blessed be.
In the south, I call the pagans to join our circle this night and bid you welcome. Hail and welcome, blessed be.
Hail and welcome, blessed be.
In the west, I call the powers of water to join our circle this night and bid you welcome. Hail and welcome, blessed be.
Hail and welcome, blessed be.
In the north, I call the powers of earth to join our circle this night and bid you welcome. Hail and welcome, blessed be.
Hail and welcome, blessed be.
And I want you all to feel the joining of all the elements as we create this sacred space. As I call your spirit to this circle, I call to this elemental spirit with love and trust to be with us this night and bid you welcome. Hail and welcome. Blessed be.
Hail and welcome, blessed be.
Hail, great goddess, as the chains of your wintry prison have fallen away, now is a greening. When the delicate scent of flowers drifts on the breeze, the cycle begins anew and life rekindles itself by your magic. The god stretches and arises, fervent in his youth and bursting with the promise of summer as we welcome you this night.
Hail, great God, young Lord of the day, we born at winter solstice. Come, join us and bring us light, joy, and energy as we celebrate the spring equinox, that magical time when light and dark are in balance. As we rise to meet you, young lord, we welcome you this night. Hail and welcome, blessed be.
Hail and
welcome, blessed
be.
From now until the lusty month of May, if you feel spring, it encompasses all the changes that the earth's weather is capable of. At winter solstice, we celebrated the rebirth of the sun and the success of our many harvests. At Imbolc, we set our sights on the year ahead of us and considered what we would like to achieve this time around. And now at Ostara, we finalize our plans and take the first steps in making them manifest by planting the seeds of our desires and by acting in accordance with our goals that we want to accomplish. So part of the spell work I want you guys to do this season is, along with that beautiful egg that you've boiled, or if you have one of the plastic ones, whichever way, we'll do both so that way you'll have it covered. For your spell work this season, I want you guys to start to take stock of yourself where you are right now. While the world is quiet, not quite at peace at the moment, but we can create our own peace right where we are right now. And I want you guys to review your current life and take stock of your emotions towards yourselves, others, and yes, there are many events that's going on in our lives right now. And I want you to step back without blame and take a look at how you and your actions have contributed to the event, good or bad, in your life. And for those things that are working well for you, I want you to commend yourself. Give yourself some credit and think of something you can do as a celebration. The ones that have the boiled eggs, like yes. I said, the water that you have that's blessed on your altar, after you've written all of it, wet the parchment paper, and you wrap it around your egg, and you hold it like this. And it's ingesting with you saying, this is what I want to accomplish. This is what I want to see to manifest this coming year. The earth is my body. Her water is my blood. The winds are my breath. And the fire is my spirit. Earth, my body, water, my blood. Air, my breath, and fire, my spirit. Earth, my body, water, my blood. Air, my breath, and fire, my spirit. Earth, my body, water, my blood. Air, my breath, and fire, my spirit. Earth, my body, water, my blood. Air, my breath, and fire, my spirit. Accomplished this from singing that, hold on to it with both hands and pour that energies of everyone into it. All our wishes, all our manifestations that we want to have this coming season. So let it be.
So let it be.
Okay. Look at that. See, by the time you finish, it's usually plastered to the egg.
Yeah.
And depending on when what you've written, when you move it, you will see some of it written on the egg.
Upon these plates are gifts from the Lord and Lady, barrels for us to enjoy, growing grains, fruits, and seeds of our mother to nourish us so that we may embody the same rebirth our Mother Earth experiences at this time. They bring us sustenance to fill our hunger. We bless these cakes in all your many names as we partake of these foods of the gods and goddesses. May you never hunger.
May we never hunger.
Never hunger.
We bring the fruit of the vine, blessed nectar flowing forth from the reawakening earth. Let us feel the rebirth and vibrant energy of all things green and growing as we partake of these wines and juices. Bless these drinks of the gods and goddesses. May you never thirst.
May you never thirst. And to the Lady and the Lord of Ostara, we wish you all the many blessings. that they wish to bestow upon us all. May we never hunger.
Gracious Mitten, goddess of our beautiful earth, we do thank you for your gifts of spring and for your presence within our hearts and our celebration. Until once again we call, we bid you hail and farewell, blessed be.
Hail and farewell, blessed be.
Young Lord of the season, we do thank you for your bright energy you have brought within our souls and to our celebration. And we look forward to with delight to your increased light. Until once again we call, we bid you hail and farewell, blessed be.
Hail and farewell, blessed be.
And we wish to thank you, Spirit, for being with us this night, Spirit. And we bid you hail and farewell, blessed be.
Hail and farewell, blessed be.
In the north, powers of earth, we thank you for being here this night and bid you farewell. Hail and farewell, blessed be.
Hail and farewell, blessed be.
In the west, powers of water, we thank you for being here this night and bid you farewell. Hail and farewell, blessed be.
Hail and farewell, blessed be.
In the south, powers of fire, we thank you for being here this night. Hail and farewell, blessed be.
Hail and farewell, blessed be.
In the east, the powers of air, we thank you for being here this night. We bid you farewell. Hail and farewell, blessed be.
Hail and farewell, blessed be.
May all beings and elementals attracted to this rite of spring depart on their way, harming none. Be of one mind. Do good unto all. And may the gods and goddesses of the spring equinox bring peace to dwell within you and bless you all in this coming season. So mote it be. If you all hold hands virtually.
The circle is open, but remains unbroken. Merry meet, merry meet,
merry
meet,
merry
meet again.
Merry meet again.
Merry meet, everyone.
Beautiful.